Welcome to week 5 of the Lewiston Public Library Children's Department's summer reading program, Tales and Tales. And this week is Reptile Week. And this is it a reptile? Are you ready to guess? So let's start with just a few quick points about what is a reptile. Do you know? Well, thankfully, I work in a library, so I have lots of books around to tell me, like this one called Reptiles by Mark Hutchinson. And according to this book and many others, a reptile is an air-breathing animal that has scales and is cold-blooded. So it uses the air or rock or water around it to modify its body temperature, to heat it up or cool it down. So they usually live in warm places. Like, you're not gonna find any reptiles in Antarctica. Let's start with that one that we just saw in that picture, the introduction to this video. Can you guess if this is a reptile? Yeah, it's scaly. See all the scales? You can see really big scales here. This is a blue iguana. A blue iguana. That's pretty cool, huh? They live in the Cayman Islands. Do you think that's a warm place? Remember, they gotta live in a warm place, pretty much. Let me get my globe here. Let's see if we can find the Cayman Islands. Well, here's Maine. Don't, up here. Oh, I got some glare. Let's get rid of the glare. Here's Maine, and if we go down the coast, we go to Boston and New York and all the way down to Florida, and down here's Cuba. Oh, there's the Cayman Islands. That's a pretty warm place. That's where the blue iguanas live. Did you know there's also a pink iguana? Pink is for blobfish. This is another really cool book we have at the library where all the animals are pink, including an iguana. I know, right? Here's a picture of it. Pink is for a pink land iguana. Do you think they live in the Cayman Islands too? Well, they live in another island called the Galapagos Islands. Pink iguana. And the Galapagos Islands aren't that far from the Cayman Islands. So if we go, let's start with Maine again. And we work our way down the coast to Florida and Cuba, and there's the Cayman Islands. We need to go down a little further, down Central America, down to South America, and we find Ecuador and the Galapagos Islands are off the coast of Ecuador. So they're not that super far from Maine, kind of in the same general area of the world. The Galapagos Islands. Okay, so thank you, pink and blue iguanas. Next is a toad. Is a toad a reptile? It's a little tricky. They look like reptiles. Are those scales? Let's see what the book says. This is gonna give it away. This book is called Amphibian. A toad is not a reptile. They kind of look like reptiles, but these are not scales. This is skin. Amphibians breathe through their skin, so they have soft skin. Even though toads kind of look reptile-ish, they are in fact in the same family as frogs. Amphibians. Okay, so my next question is a sea turtle, like this one, a reptile? It lives in the ocean, and reptiles don't usually live in the ocean, do they? This sea turtle is called a loggerhead turtle, and it's in this great book that we have here at the library, The Ultimate Oceanpedia, All Things Ocean. Let's see what the book says. It's a reptile. Do you see the scales? These are scales. Turtles are reptiles, even if they live in the ocean. Did you guess that right? Good job. The next question is a dinosaur a reptile? A dinosaur, like these hadrosaurs in our Smithsonian dinosaur book. Now, this is a tricky answer. If you said yes, you'd be correct. And if you said no, you'd be correct. And that is because there is a lot of debate about whether dinosaurs are reptiles or if they are birds. I know, right? They look like reptiles to me, but there's a lot of evidence that shows they're actually related more closely related to birds than reptiles. So that's your call. Some books are gonna say one and some are gonna say the other. But if you wanna find out more, we have a ton of awesome dinosaur books here at the library. This is just one of them. This is one of my favorite animals. Let's see if you can guess if it's a reptile or not. It's a chameleon. Is that a reptile? Here's a picture of one. Isn't that cute? It's a baby chameleon and its eyes can go different directions. Look closely, do you see scales? You do? Yes, it is a reptile. It's one of the most famous reptiles because chameleons can change color and their eyes go different directions. And they're super cute. The next question is a pangolin a reptile? This is a picture of a pangolin. This is from a wonderful book we have called Odd Animals, and this is an easy reader book. It's got very simple words and big pictures. This is a pangolin. What do you think? Reptile or not? Those look like scales, don't they? Well, let's see. The book says, not a reptile. A pangolin is a mammal. A mammal is covered in fur or hair. So, what? Aren't those scales? Actually, no. This is a kind of hair. It's not hair exactly, but it's kind of a form of hair, specialized. It's called keratin. I think it's the sort of thing that's on our nails more than our hair. But a pangolin is a mammal, not a reptile. Are you ready for the next one? Are salamanders reptiles? These are some salamanders and, well, a salamander and a newt. Do these look like reptiles? This one kind of does. It's got some bumpy skin there. But this one's shiny and smooth. So if you guessed not a reptile, you are correct. This is from our book again, Amphibian. Salamanders and newts, especially sometimes, look a lot like geckos. Geckos are very fun kind of reptile called a lizard. You've probably seen them on a wall. They're like lizard ninjas. They can like jump and stick on stuff with their sticky toes. But these are amphibians because they have soft skin that they breathe through. So not a lizard. We're getting close to the end. Are you ready for the next one? Is this a reptile? It looks kind of like a leaf. Is it a reptile? What do you think? Well, this book is called Lizards, and all lizards are reptiles. So if you guessed yes, it's a reptile, you are correct. This is a leaf gecko. And it's very good at hiding. It looks so much like a leaf that you can't even tell it's there. Pretty cool, huh? Here's a tricky one. This is a glass snake. A glass snake. Do you think that's a reptile? You're right, it is a reptile. But it's not a snake. This is a reptile that has a wrong name, kind of. It's actually a kind of lizard. Now, it looks like a snake to me, too, but apparently the glass snake can blink. And snakes cannot blink. Did you know that? So it can be very tricky to figure things out sometimes, but we have lots of cool books to help you find the answers. Come on into Lewiston Public Library and we'll be happy to find some for you. And we've still got take and make kits with a reptile theme that have games and fun activities in them. And one last thing, the secret code for this program is turtle. Turtle. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye-bye.